morning. How'd you sleep?
I couldn't stop thinking about
you. You're so sweet.
So what did you do last night?
Homework.
Why couldn't you FaceTime?
Hey, how's your day been?
Better if it was with you. How was school?
Good. I got partnered up with my friend Jake for a bio project.
Who's Jake?
Good morning. I love you. I miss you.
When can I see you?
I'm still grounded.
Can you sneak out?
Hey!
What are you doing right now? Can you come over?
Sorry, I'm going over to Mila's house.
Is anyone else gonna be there?
Just friends from school.
Like Jake?
I don't know, maybe.
I bet you'll have more fun with him. Hey, are you mad? Why haven't you gotten back to me? Hello? Are you with
you,
Jake?
Where are you?
Why are you ignoring me?
Why are you doing this to me?
I still have the pills you told me to get rid of. I'm gonna do it!
Hey, I'm so sorry. My phone died. I didn't bring my charger to school. Are you okay? Can you please call me when you get this? Hey, did you get any of my messages? I'm so sorry.
If you're sorry, why don't you send a picture that'll cheer me up?
I'm at dinner with my family.
You can run to the bathroom.
I don't know, maybe later.
Not now, you owe it to me.
I don't think I
can. Are you breaking up with me? I can't.
I just don't want to be in this relationship.
You're the only person I care about. I bet you never even
don't
want to break up with me. I'll kill myself.
I'm sorry, are you there?
You have reached the voicemail box of...
Please don't do this.
I love you. There are teenage girls everywhere being taught that this is love. Love is not putting your partner's satisfaction before your own safety. Love is not jealousy dressed as protection. Love is not confusing your body for his midnight snack. Love is not being forced into anything, even when he has you convinced that you want this. I thought my spread legs could heal his broken. I sacrificed my comfort in an attempt to comfort him, even after he begged me to get him off in a parking lot.
Even after he forced his hand on my skirt in a movie theater.
Even after I said no, we are taught to swallow our protest in exchange for his apology. When I miss him, I miss only the warmth. I do not think about the burn marks.
The mornings I could not keep my breakfast down,
mistaking anxiety for butterflies.
In our first 2 months together, I lost 16 pounds to palpitations and weak stomach.
Whenever my phone rings at night, I still think it's his 2 a.m. suicide call.
Every time my phone vibrates, I still lose my appetite.
When my friends ask me why I stayed so long, why I accepted the roses and ignored the thorns, I tell them it is not easy to weed out the roots he planted in me.
I tell them I was so captivated by the house he built for me.
I didn't notice the locked door. I didn't notice I was captive to this garden of guilt.
I tell them I tried leaving,
but he held a gun to his head, and I feared my escape would have been what pulled the trigger. We are tired of this guilt that must mean girl, the unrecognizable victim.
Who fell in love with a warning sign.
If his fists ever meet your face, do not confuse it for sparks flying.
Oh, your body will bloom in bruises.
There is nothing romantic about a bouquet of black eyes. I am tired of holding thorns.
Baby,
did you never feel the blood between our held hands? Or did you just mistake it for tears of your own? Because of you,
the number you dialed has been changed, disconnected, or is no longer in service.
Goodbye.